Welcome back, guys. So today we are going to discuss the storage skills that you require when you are trying to be an infrastructure engineer. Now, if you are new to this channel, I'm putting together a series of videos that will help you become an infrastructure engineer and also explain what this role consists of. So I have covered what the roles and responsibilities are for an infra engineer and the Linux and networking skills you require, which are the two most important parts of any infra, and this is something that you will be working on most of the times. When it comes to storage, this is going to be a short video because the storage basically falls into on-prem and cloud, and it depends which kind of storage the company that you work at is going to use. But in the following sections, we will go over the basic understanding of how storage is divided in any infrastructure and the basic troubleshooting skills for this role. So let's start with the two types of storage that you will basically encounter in any infrastructure. One is called NAS, which is Network Area Storage, and the second one is called SAN, which is Storage Area Network. So in NAS, you have NFS, which you will be using in any infrastructure. I think the version that we use now is NFS version 4, but most of the companies would be on NFS version 3 as far as I know. And NFS is quite an old technology. It's basically there's one storage space where everyone writes the data, and that data is being shared with various devices through the network. So it's called Network Area Storage. So the storage is accessible from various network areas. So it's NAS. The problem when it comes to NAS is there's a single point of failure, which basically means that if the storage where everyone is writing goes down, so everyone loses the data, which is not ideal when you work in a corporate sector because data costs a lot of money. So whenever there's a single point of failure, you will always need backup. So when it comes to NAS, backup is very important because once you lose the data, you can just recover the backup, and that way most of your data is back. So backup is very important, and the backup strategies, there are various strategies that you can look into, but you won't be dealing with any of these. The main issue that would come to you would be like about read-write errors. So there, someone would say that they are seeing read-write errors on the storage device or whenever they are trying to access any storage location. One more thing that you would see is basically people telling that it's taking a lot of time to copy files or to access or write into any files, which means that there is latency in the network. So you will need to figure out which network it is using, how is their latency, and basically engage the storage team with these details. So in the next section, we will cover SAN and go over some details about SAN. So let's talk about SAN, which is called a Storage Area Network. Now, when it comes to SAN, it means that it is still a network, like servers are still accessing data from a network. But in case of SAN, there are multiple storage devices. When you were dealing with NAS, there was a single point of failure. So everything was written in one location, and if that location is unavailable for some reason, you lose the data unless you have any backup. When it comes to SAN, there are multiple storage devices and they all have the data, and you can access data from any one of these. And they have various RAID levels. We won't get into RAID, and it also depends on the company architecture which RAID levels they are going to use on the storage devices. But these storage devices are very fault tolerant, which basically means that there's a high availability, and if one of the storage devices goes down, there are other ones that are still accessible and your data is not lost because it is accessible through the other storage devices. One of the important things when it comes to SAN is that the data consistency should be pretty good across all the storage devices. So that's one of the most important things about SAN. So I think that's it for SAN. In the next section, we'll discuss some basic terminology that you should know when it comes to storage devices. SAN is very much faster than NAS. And the reason behind SAN being faster than NAS is because the network that is connected in SAN is through fiber optic cables, and fiber optics is way faster than your normal cable. Fiber optic basically sends the data at the speed of light. That is why SAN networks could also cost you a lot of money. So SAN networks are basically used for crucial data. When you want to store any important data in databases and you need it to be highly available and you need like quick access to it, you would put the database on SAN. But again, this is going to cost you a lot because the fiber optic channels are pretty expensive because the performance is very good. So when it comes to performance, you have good performance, but when it comes to cost, you also have higher cost. You have to give up something for the good performance. And the other thing that you can do is, instead of using fiber optics, you can use SCSI, which is, it's still faster because there are multiple storage devices and it's still faster than the usual NAS. But again, it would be a little less expensive, and because it is less expensive, the performance also would be a little less faster than what you would get with fiber optics. If cost is not a problem, you will always see a SAN network with fiber optics. So I think that is it for this section, and in the next section I'll go over some of the basic terminologies that you should know while working with storage. So let's talk about the basic terminologies that you should know when you're working with storage. So if you're interviewing and you ask what kind of storage does the company's infrastructure uses, they will either say it's a cloud storage or it's an on-prem storage. Cloud storage basically means all the data is being written to the cloud. When it comes to AWS, they will give you EFS, which is Elastic File Storage, and EBS, which is Elastic Block Storage, or they can also write it in S3 buckets. There are also various databases where they can write their data into. If they say it's on-prem, which means that there are on-prem storage devices that in their data centers, that is on the ground, that is managed and accessed by the data centers, and all the data is being stored on-prem. You will also hear about fiber optics or fiber channels. Just remember, whenever someone says fiber, it means high speed. So if someone says we have fiber cables, it's going to cost a lot because they are very fast. You'll also hear terms like replication or snapshots. So snapshots is basically if you have a server which supports 10 applications and then you are trying to install 3 more applications, so you create a snapshot of the server, which means like taking a picture of the server at that particular moment with 10 applications. And when you add 3 more applications, and suppose the server goes down, it is not able to properly come up because you messed something up during installing and the server is unusable. What you can do is, in that scenario, you can go back in time to that snapshot where the server had 10 applications and use that snapshot, which will basically tell the server that come back to this point where you had 10 applications and these 3 applications were not installed. So when you recover that snapshot, you kind of go back in the time for that server or for that virtual machine, and your server is back. Replication is different than snapshots. Replication basically means duplication of data. It's like a fancy term for duplicating your data, which is like backup. You'll also hear some things like DR, which is disaster recovery. That's like the worst case scenario. So some companies will do DR testing, which means that they would purposely pull out the cables from their storage devices. When a failure occurs, how the data would fall over to the backup and how long it would take for them to recover everything and get back in business. So these are some kind of like testing that they would do. And whenever you hear DR, just remember it means disaster recovery. So in case of earthquake or there's like a power outage in all the data centers, what would happen to your storage? You can't just lose everything because the power went out. You need to plan for the worst case scenario. In this case, it would be the DR scenario. There would always be some plan on how to handle these situations. You don't have to deal with it, but then again, it's good to know because you are an infrastructure engineer. If something happens in infra, you should know. If they are talking about DR, you can't ask them what is DR because you should know these things. There are different types of hard disk, and sometimes on storage devices, you will hear SSDs or HDD. HDD is the hard disk which has like a spindle on the circular thing. I actually forgot what it's called, but the spindle actually writes 1 or 0 on the circular disk. And whenever you use a normal hard disk, you can hear the rotations of the spindle. So that's the noise that's being made by the spindle. I'll put a picture to show how it actually looks like. And the new kind of storage that most people use now is called SSD, which is like a flash drive, which means that everything is written in memory. Again, with flash drives, they don't have the spindle. Everything is just written and read from. So it's going to be expensive, but it's way faster. But that's all you need to know. One of the important things that you will have to answer while working as an infrastructure engineer is whenever users complain about read-write errors or they complain about latency while getting a file, you have to understand that if it's a storage issue or it's a database issue. When they say about read-write, it's very tricky because they could be reading and writing from a database or they could be reading or writing into a storage location. So it is very important to ask them, are they writing on NFS? Are they writing on a database? You need to gather more information to know if it's a database issue or a storage issue. Because at the end, you are the infrastructure engineer. So you are supposed to know what is going on in the infrastructure and you are supposed to know where the problem is and whom to engage for this problem. So I think that is it for the storage one. Again, I said it would be very basic because the main issues that you come across would be with Linux and networks. Storage is good to know. You won't be troubleshooting much on storage unless you have permissions. But I think that's it for this video, guys, and I will see you guys in the next one.